Greetings, Benjamin J from Ben's Trains with another in the series. Well, I wanted to do a quick video on these plastic Marx cars. Now, as you see, these two are two plastic tenders. I've added a rear spotlight to this one. And I went on eBay and found some battery packs with a built-in knife switch. As you see, you got five of these for, I don't know, $3, $2, something like that, free shipping. Really, really inexpensive. Of course, they came from China, so it took 3 weeks to get here. Anyway, takes two AA batteries, standard pin light batteries. The nice thing about these, of course, is in this case, I've just got it stuck to the inside of this car and instant on-off switch. As you see, really simple to do this. Add some heft to the car. So it's definitely worth going to the trouble of building one. Gives you a lighted tender. It looks nice. It costs virtually nothing. It's one of those spotlights. You can get these at Menards. I found two packages of them at the dollar store, Dollar Tree, in fact. Anyway, I got it wired directly to this battery pack. Two pin light batteries will run this thing for probably 2 weeks if you leave it on. It'll run it for a long, long time. Anyway, it has a built-in knife switch, so it makes it really, really simple to use. No separate switch needed. And for mounting it in a tender like this, just use mounting tabs and you just literally stick it in there. It's easy to get the batteries in and out. Switch is right there. Instant on-off, as you see. And it gives the car some heft. Anyway, so there's that one. And then I wanted to cover a video on these square wooden dowels. And you can pick these up at Home Depot, Ace Hardware, Builders Emporium, Lowe's, anywhere. And they're really cheap. The nice thing about them is you can do really great repairs with this thing. For example, here's a tender. The front coupler was broken off. The stanchion was broken off, as you see. And once it's broken that badly, there's no way to repair it. It's too short to do anything with it. So all you do is pull off the front wheel, take a piece of this plastic or this wooden dowel, cut it to fit, epoxy it, and attach a tab and slot coupler to it. As you see, really, really simple to do this. It only takes a minute, and it's a great repair. Literally, it only takes a minute to do it. As you see, you would never know just by looking at it that that car was ever broken. It's an instant repair. It'll last virtually the rest of your life. No muss, no fuss. Just cut it to fit, epoxy it between the two side plates. And this is how I fixed that Marx motor the other day. Exact same thing. It works. It's a real expedient. It works really well. It's simple. It's quick. It's really inexpensive. You buy one of these dowels, you can get them for, I don't know, $2, something like that. Really, really cheap, and you can repair a lot of stuff with this exact same application. And one last thing to cover today. I went down to Walmart yesterday to get some hand sanitizer, and they didn't have any. I mean, the shelves were completely empty. A great expedient is get a bottle of 99% isopropyl alcohol and put a spray nozzle on it. As you see, I mean, this is 99%, so this stuff dries virtually instantly, kills all the germs on your hands. It only takes a minute, no muss, no fuss. It's really inexpensive. Best of all, it works. And you can spray it on the doorknobs, you can spray it on your cell phone, you can spray it on your hands, you can spray it on virtually anything. It's a great way to keep your hands clean, especially with this coronavirus stuff going on. Anyway, I just want to do a quick video on a couple of these plastic cars and a really simple expedient to, in this case, add a light to the back of this one. Using these battery packs. Like I said, got these things on eBay, five for, I forget, they worked out to be 27 cents a piece, something like that. Of course, it did take 3 weeks to get here from China, but they're simple and you can take virtually any car, add a spotlight to it, add an LED to it, add LEDs to it, and just stick it to the inside of the car with some foam mounting tabs. Has an instant on-off switch, as you see. And it adds some heft to the car. So it's actually a great improvement. It looks nice. It works really well. Like I said, it's just an expedient. And then using these wooden dowels, to do these repairs. Like I said, with that stanchion, as you see, broken off as low as it is, there's no practical, simple way to repair that. It becomes a junk car, and you can use the wheels off of it or snag the other coupler, but for all intent and purpose, it's broken. It's the end of the line. It winds up in the parts box. But a really simple expedient to repair it: take one of the plastic or the wooden dowels, cut it to fit, as you see, epoxy it in place, and then you can attach a coupler directly to it, and your plastic car is up and running. Really simple. And like I said, looking at it, you'd never know that that was ever broken. It works really, really well. So a really simple expedient for both of these cars, as you see. This one has a light on the back with that knife switch battery pack. It works. It's really, really cheap. It only takes a minute to install it. Just stick it into the car with a couple of foam mounting tabs, as you see. Only takes a minute to do this. And it's virtually instant. It works well. Has a built-in switch. Those two AA batteries will power this light virtually forever. I mean, it'll run constantly. It'll run probably a week, something like that. Anyway, I just wanted to do a quick video. Starting to warm up today. 51 degrees. Warmest day we've had in weeks. So, just want to do a quick video on the plastic cars and, of course, a really, really simple alternative to hand sanitizer. So, as always, if you have any questions, feel free to drop me an email, benstrains@gmail.com. And as always, thank you for watching.